Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves. In a town in Persia there dwelt two brothers, one named Kasim, the other Ali Baba. Kasim was married to a rich wife and lived in plenty, while Ali Baba had to maintain his wife and children by cutting wood in a neighboring forest and selling it in the town. One day, when Ali Baba was in the forest, he saw a troop of men on horseback coming towards him in a cloud of dust. He was afraid they were robbers and climbed into a tree for safety. When they came up to him and dismounted, he counted 40 of them. They unbridled their horses and tied them to trees. The finest man among them, whom Ali Baba took to be their captain, went a little way among some bushes and said, "Open, Sesame," so plainly that Ali Baba heard him. A door opened in the rocks, and having made the troop go in, he followed them, and the door shut again of itself. They stayed some time inside, and Ali Baba, fearing they might come out and catch him, was forced to sit patiently in the tree. At last the door opened again, and the 40 thieves came out. As the captain went in last, he came out first, and made them all pass by him. He then closed the door, saying, "Shut, Sesame." Every man bridled his horse and mounted. The captain put himself at their head, and they returned as they came. Then Ali Baba climbed down and went to the door concealed among the bushes, and said, "Open, Sesame," and it flew open. Ali Baba, who expected a dull, dismal place, was greatly surprised to find it large and well lighted, and hollowed by the hand of man in the form of a vault, which received the light from an opening in the ceiling. He saw rich bales of merchandise, silk, stuff brocades, all piled together, and gold and silver in heaps, and money in leather purses. He went in, and the door shut behind him. He did not look at the silver, but brought out as many bags of gold as he thought his asses, which were browsing outside, could carry, loaded them with the bags, and hid it all with faggots. Using the words, "Shut, Sesame," he closed the door and went home. Then he drove his asses into the yard, shut the gates, carried the money bags to his wife, and emptied them out before her. He bade her keep the secret, and he would go and bury the gold. "Let me first measure it," said his wife. "I will go borrow a measure of someone while you dig the hole." So she ran to the wife of Kasim and borrowed a measure. Knowing Ali Baba's poverty, the sister was curious to find out what sort of grain his wife wished to measure, and artfully put some suet at the bottom of the measure. Ali Baba's wife went home and set the measure on the heap of gold, and filled it and emptied it often, to her great content. She then carried it back to her sister, without noticing that a piece of gold was sticking to it, which Kasim's wife perceived directly her back was turned. She grew very curious, and said to Kasim when he came home, "Kasim, your brother is richer than you. He does not count his money, he measures it." He begged her to explain this riddle, which she did by showing him the piece of money and telling him where she found it. Then Kasim grew so envious that he could not sleep, and went to his brother in the morning before sunrise. "Ali Baba," he said, showing him the gold piece, "you pretend to be poor and yet you measure gold." By this Ali Baba perceived that through his wife's folly, Kasim and his wife knew their secret. So he confessed all and offered Kasim a share. "That I expect," said Kasim, "but I must know where to find the treasure, otherwise I will discover all, and you will lose all." Ali Baba, more out of kindness than fear, told him of the cave and the very words to use. Kasim left Ali Baba, meaning to be beforehand with him and get the treasure himself. He rose early next morning and set out with 10 mules loaded with great.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.